Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the status bar in Microsoft Excel. Excel has long had a status bar located at the bottom of your worksheets, but for most people, they don't really know how to fully make use of it. Today, I'm going to show you a couple of quick tips on how to make better use of the status bar. Here you'll see I have my Excalibur paper sales data for my entire team, as well as my top five sales associates for last month, as well as the unfortunate people in my bottom five salespeople. But what I need to do is I actually need to pull the report for my boss, and what he's asked me for is the average sales figures for the team as a whole, as well as the average sales figures for my top five and my bottom five. To do this, I can simply highlight all of the sales figures, and in the home row of my ribbon, I can use the drop-down menu next to the auto sum option, and I'll have an option for average, which when I click this, you'll see will give me the average sales figures for the team as a whole. I could then simply choose to copy and paste this data, but I'd only need to use it just for my reports. So I don't want it in my spreadsheet all the time. So I'm going to undo that, and I'm going to show you a faster way just to get the data I need. I simply highlight all of my data, and in the status bar down in the bottom right-hand corner of Excel, you'll see I currently have the total as well as the fact that there are 15 items currently highlighted. If I right-click on the status bar, I'll get a bunch of different options that I can then choose to show on my status bar. In this case, I'm going to show the average, and I'll also show the minimum and maximum as well. Now you'll see my status bar has all of this extra information, including the average that is the data that I am actually looking to get. Our latest updates to Excel have now enabled the feature where I can simply left-click on any of these numbers and it will automatically put it into my clipboard, and then I can Control-V and paste it anywhere I need, which means that to get my top five salespeople's average, I simply highlight, click the average number down in the status bar and paste it where I need. Same thing for my bottom five salespeople, and I haven't had to modify my spreadsheet in any way, shape or form in order to get that information and put it into my clipboard. And that is how you use the status bar in Excel. I hope you found this tip useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.